Hello, hello. This is Chris, your financially sassy woman, coming to see you again this morning. I am a financial coach. This is what I love to do. I started this group here so that I could give some information, knowledge to some of my girlfriends and kind of spread. So, invite your friends, come on over, and let me invite some people. This is keeping it real with Chris. It's funny, it picks a few people for me to send invites to. All right. So let's get started. Today is Wonder Woman Wednesday. You know what? We are all Wonder Woman. Check this out. I got this a while ago. I actually had it made. Let me see how I can show it to you. Wonder Woman. It's kind of big, but I believe that we are all Wonder Woman. Okay? And I believe when we work together, nobody can stop us. We can do big things, and I think we should. Yesterday, I posted the jargon of the day, and it was, what does ROI mean? That means return on investment. So you can talk about return on investment when it comes to money or your time. And the reason I say keeping it real with Chris is today I am working at home again, and I have my dog here. She may want to come and visit. But anyhow, so, hello, hello. If you're here, let me know. Say hello. Give me some love. Just let me know you're here. On the replay now, whenever you see this. Okay, so we were talking about the return on investment. Return on investment, I gave you some samples, some examples, and I wanted you to let me know if you thought that it was a good return on investment or not a good return on investment. Good morning, Jen. And not a lot of you replied. I would love it if you would still go look at it and let me know what you think, because return on investment is something that we all need to know about. This includes, okay, you think about it with your time. What do you spend your time on? What is your return on investment? Your time. I know for myself, okay, so I have my clients, and the return on investment is basically, they're going to know how to do their finances, and they're going to be confident when it comes to their finances. However, they have to feel like it's a good return on investment. If I am able to help somebody find $10,000, if I charge them $1,000, do you think that is a good return on investment? A car. Do you think a car? Good morning, Amanda. Do you think a car is a good investment? You buy a car for $40,000, and like today, you buy it today, $40,000. In 2 hours, you decide you don't want it and you want to sell it. Can you sell it for $40,000? Yes, no, maybe so. Okay, the answer really is no. You're not going to be able to sell it for $40,000. So the return on investment was not a good return on investment. The other example I used was a property. If you are able to buy a property, and I'm giving numbers from Georgia, I know there's some people in here from California, and I live there too, so I know the numbers. But here in Georgia, say you buy a house for $100,000, and you turn around and you sell it for $250,000. Was that a good return on investment? Absolutely. So what I love to do is show you how to spend your money on the right things so that you actually get a return on your money. If you buy a brand new Prada bag for $700, $1,000, whatever you pay for them, does that have a good return on investment? I mean, it may for some people, but the women that I'm talking to here are definitely wanting to know how to make their money work for them. And that is not really a good way to make your money work for you. We look good out in public, but don't really have a good return on investment. So what Wonder Woman do you know? Do you know anybody that you would consider a Wonder Woman? Like I said, I believe that we all are in our own way. We all have something to offer the world. What do you have? Share. What would be one thing that you would love if you could talk to your younger self? What would you talk to yourself about? Especially like say when it comes to money, what would be the one thing you think that you should have known or you would have liked to known when you were younger? One more thing before I run off. September is Life Insurance Awareness Month. So I will continue to bring that up until the end of this month. I know a lot of people feel like it is something they don't want to do, but how many times do you see people having a, hey, and this could be also a good return on investment, because imagine if this is kind of sad, but I've had a client who, his father-in-law purchased him a life insurance policy. $1 million life insurance policy. He bought it because he wanted his daughter to be taken care of if anything were ever to happen to him. He had the policy for 9 months. He paid into it. And I mean, he was young, so it wasn't expensive at all. 9 months later, he found out that he had throat cancer. Now, do you think he put $1 million into this policy in 9 months? Absolutely not. I think for the kid, I think he had put in maybe, I can't even remember the numbers, it's been a couple years ago, $500 maybe. And his family, when he found out that he had cancer, the insurance company will give him 90% of his death benefit. That's something new. Most people don't have living benefits on their life insurance policy. If you have a life insurance, check it out. See if you have a living benefits, because this is something you definitely want. For him, it was great because the life insurance company gave him 90% of his death benefit. So he got $900,000, and this is tax-free. And he was able to take that money and go to his own country where he came from, and he was actually cured. They told him here in the States that there was nothing that they could do for him, and told him he had less than like 6 months to live. And he was able to go to his own country and get cured. So now he has all this money. What's he going to do with it? Well, hopefully after that happened, he ended up staying in his country. But hopefully if you live here in the States and something like that were to happen, we would have a plan set aside for you that it wouldn't get spent, because that's what happens to people if their mindset never changes. If they live exactly the way they grew up, that's why so many people that win the lottery end up broke like within a year. And also I've had clients that their husbands have passed away and they received $700,000 and blew through it in a year, less than a year. So the thing is, let's think about life insurance this month, and since it's September, if you have any questions, let me know. If you need a review, I can help you with that. And also, I wanted to say, I know that there's been some people that have been wanting to post their events in this group, and I'm fine with that, but I would love it if you would engage in the community before you just come and slap an ad in the group. Because I don't want this group to be a group where we're just spamming each other with sales. I don't want it to be a salesy type of group. I want us all to rise together and support each other. So if you have an event that you want to share, you can do that here. But just make sure that you're also sharing in the community or are commenting on our videos. And please also invite your friends. If you have any girlfriends that you think could benefit from anything that we talk about here in this group, please invite them. Don't forget, ladies, we are all Wonder Woman. Wonder Women together. Let's rise. Have a good day. I will be posting your jargon of the day a little bit later this afternoon. All right. Have a good one. Bye-bye.